In the previous series of tutorials, we have learned how to create this floor plan. Now, in this tutorial, we will learn technique to create front elevation from existing floor plan. If you want to see more such type of videos, then subscribe to my channel, and to receive immediate notification, press the bell icon. And if you want to learn how to create this floor plan, link to that complete playlist is given in the description. At first, we will create this plinth of 600 height. Now here, the second line is of plinth. To make plinth layer current, click here on make current and click on this line. So here, plinth layer got current. Zoom it, pan it below. To project this plinth line, click here on draw and click on construction line. We want to create vertical construction lines. For that, click on VER, click on these plinth points. To create ground, we will need one horizontal line. For that, press enter. Press enter to repeat last command. Click on HOR and click here. We want plinth at the gap of 600. Press enter. Enter. Click on offset. Specify offset distance of 600. Enter. Click on this line. Take your cursor above and click. Press enter to stop X line command. To remove unwanted portion, click here on fillet. Click on multiple, then select this line, and this line. Press enter. Type TR for trim. Press enter. Press enter and remove these following three lines and this line. Enter. So this plinth is ready. Next is we will project this wall lines. For that, again click on make current and click on this wall lines. So wall layer will become current. You can give construction line by typing XL. To create construction line, command name is XLine. Press enter. Click on VER. Click on these wall lines. We want wall height to be 3000. Slab height is 150 and parapet wall height is 750. Press enter. Enter. Click on offset. Specify offset of 3000. Press enter. Select this line. Take your cursor above and click. Press enter. Click on offset. Specify gap of 150 for slab. Press enter. Click on this line. Take your cursor above and click. Again select this line. Take your cursor above. Specify height of 750 for parapet wall and press enter. Press enter to stop offset command. And we will project these slab lines also. For that, type XL, press enter, click on VER, click on these slab points. Press enter. To remove unwanted objects, type TR for trim, press enter, enter, and remove these surrounding objects. And these internal objects. Press enter. And these wall lines also needs to be removed. Type TR, enter, enter, and remove these bottom lines. Press enter. So these walls, slab and parapet wall is ready. Then next is to create this window. For that, click here and make window layer current. Then type XL, enter, click on VER. Click on these window lines and these sunshade lines. Press enter. Trim TR, enter, select this line and this line. Press enter and remove these objects. Press enter. For window, sill height is 900, window height is 1200 and sunshade height is 200. Click on offset. Specify offset distance of 900, enter. Click on this line, take your cursor above and click. Click on this line, take your cursor above. Specify height of 1200, enter. Select this line, take your cursor above. Specify height of 200, enter. Enter. Click on fillet. Click on multiple. Zoom there and click on this line, this line, this line and this line. This line, this line, this line and this line. Press enter. Trim, TR, enter. Then select this line and this line. This line and this line as reference lines. Press enter and click on these lines to be removed. Press enter. Create internal window. For that, click on rectangle. Click on this endpoint and this endpoint. Click on offset. Specify gap of 50. Enter. Click on this rectangle. Take your cursor inside and click. Then select this line. Take your cursor inside, specify gap of 25, enter, enter. Then click on line. Click on this midpoint. Click on this midpoint. Press enter. Type O for offset. Press enter. Gap of 25 is already there. Press enter. Select this line. Take your cursor on this side and click. Zoom there. Enter, trim, TR, enter, enter, and remove this line and this line. Press enter. So this window is also ready. Then this glass symbol. For that, zoom there. Click on line. Specify first point. Make ortho off. Take your cursor in this direction. Specify length of 200, press tab, specify angle of 45, enter, enter. Then offset this line, click on offset, click on through, click on this line, take your cursor in this direction, specify gap of 25, enter. Again select this line, gap of 25, enter, enter. Break these lines. Click on modify, click on break, select this line, click outside, enter, select this line, click outside, enter, repeat the same procedure, click, click, enter, click, click. Zoom minus, we want same symbol here, type CO for copy, press enter, select this object, enter. And base point will be this end point and second point will be this end point. Now I don't want this perpendicular object snap. I will turn it off. Click here on arrow near object snap and click on perpendicular. I don't want this node also. Click outside and click on this end point. Press enter. So this window is ready. Then this horizontal line hatch. Now I want this hatch in different color. For that I will create one layer. Click on layer properties. Click on new. I will name it as elevation. Click here. And suppose I will take this color. Okay. Close. Click here. Make elevation layer current. Click on hatch. Click on NC31, click here and here, then click here and select by layer. then click here, increase scale, suppose I will make it 50, enter, and to make it horizontal, type here minus 45, enter. So here this hatch is created properly. Press enter. So this window is ready. I want same window here. For that, click on copy. Select this window. Press enter. I will select this midpoint as a base point. Take your cursor to this midpoint and take it below. Make ortho on. And click here. Press enter. So this window is also ready. Next is to create side view of sunset. This height is 200 as specified here. This is 100 and this length we will track from plan. Click here, click on window, click on draw, click on construction line, click on vertical, click on this endpoint. Zoom here, enter, click on line, take your cursor to this endpoint, track it and click here. I want this line perpendicular to this point. For that, take your cursor to this midpoint and take your cursor above and click. This height is 200, type 200, enter, make ortho off and take your cursor to this midpoint and track that midpoint, click and click. Press enter, type E, enter, select this line, enter. I want same on the opposite side, click on mirror, select this object, enter, then first point of mirror line will be this midpoint, click, take your cursor below, ensure that it is tracking that midpoint and your line is vertical, click, click on no. Next is to create these steps. Click here, click on steps, type Excel, enter, click on vertical, click on this endpoint of steps, press enter, zoom there, then click on offset, then click on layer, interlayer option current, specify gap of 200, enter, click on this line, click on multiple, take your cursor above, click, click, press enter and again press enter to stop offset command. Click on line, click on this endpoint, this intersection point, this one and this one. Enter, remove these lines, type E, enter and select these lines. Press enter, zoom minus, then to apply gravels, for that click on make current, click on these lines, click on hatch, click here, scroll it down and select gravel and click inside this portion, suppose I want 20, enter, click on OK, zoom minus, then to create this ground symbol, for that copy this line, click on copy, select this line, enter, base point will be this endpoint, zoom there, take your cursor to this endpoint, track that endpoint and click, press enter, again press enter, select this object, enter, specify base point at this endpoint, click, click on array, specify number of atoms as 4, enter, then make ortho on, take your cursor here and click, press enter, then click on mirror, select these lines, enter, specify first point of mirror line here, take your cursor below and click, press enter. zoom minus. Then we will have to write GL here. For that we will copy this W, type CO, enter, select this object, enter, specify base point, make ortho off, zoom there and click, enter, double click, type GL, G dot space L dot, click outside, then move it, type M, enter, select this object, enter, specify base point and click here. We want same on this side, type CO for copy, enter, select this object, enter, specify base point here, make ortho on and click, press enter. We don't want these lines, click on modify, click on break, click here and here, enter, click here and here, type E, enter and select this line, enter. Then to write front elevation, copy this GL, type CO, enter, select the GL, enter, specify base point, make ortho off and click here, enter, double click, type there front elevation and increase length, select this text, click on bold, click here, make it Arial black, increase height to 250, enter and click on underline, click outside, move M, enter, select this object, enter and place it roughly in the center, zoom minus, same way plan, copy, enter, select this object, enter, base point, click, enter, double click and type plan, click, move it in the center, M, enter, select, enter, base point and click. We want this front elevation on the top. Before that, remove these lines, E, enter, select these lines, enter, move this elevation, type M, enter, select this object, enter, specify base point, make ortho on, take your cursor above and click. Then these dimensions, zoom there, click here, click on dim, click on dimension, click on this endpoint, take your cursor here and click. Click on continue, click on this dimension and click on this endpoint and this endpoint. Press enter, enter, then click on this endpoint, take your cursor on this side and click. Click on continue, click on this dimension, click on this endpoint, enter, enter. And one more enter to stop dimension command. Click on this 150 dimension, take your cursor on this grip, click on above dim line, click on this grip, take it outside and click. Same way here, click, take your cursor on this grip, click on above dim line, press escape. So these dimensions are also ready. In the next tutorial, we will create cross section. And if you want to receive notification for my next video, then please subscribe and click on bell icon. So thanks for watching. We will stop here.